are back for the second half. Where was the halftime show, huh? Oh, how's everybody doing tonight? We're sitting here about 4:45 in the morning. Hurting like a motherfucker. And it's time to get absolutely blazed. I didn't get too medicated yesterday. I was just holding off for this review. Hopefully everybody's had a fantastic day. You know, everybody's grows are going great. Everybody's, you know, goals are being, you know, fulfilled or at least worked on. You know, you got a goal. You can't, you know, it's like the lottery. You ain't gonna win if you ain't play, you know. You ain't gonna win if you don't play. Kombucha. Kombucha. Where's our papers at here? I don't even know how many followers we have now. I'm sure excited. I'm really excited to give somebody some really good genetics. Like, we got some... I've been calling it the Hell's Line. I know a lot of people be interested in that Hell's Line. That's for sure. Kombucha! I know we started going over this. We started going over... I think we had about one puff of that, and then it was like time to get the hell off because we're out of space. All right. I've just been stressing this plant out. I took it out of the flower room about 4 days ago. It's ready. It's done. It's done growing. But I've been placing it at the door, you know, it's minus 40 outside, and making it freeze a bit, giving her some cold-ass air, frosting her up some, stressing it out, cutting off leaves here and there, and I'm also taking razor blades to the stalks in random places. Not too deep of a cut now, because at this point of the game, that can cause a lot of problems. With, like, infection or disease or whatever the fuck, and also they'll snap right off now. Yeah, I've been stressing her out. I can see the frost has intensified since I've been doing that. Without a doubt. Without a doubt. And it's getting stressed out too, because it's like the time's all fucked up now, right? I'd have to say, since I've been doing this, it's gained at least 3/4 of an inch of this, like, calyx on the top. It's just rock fucking solid. And these peakers on the tops of each one of the buds. Oh, damn. If only these plants still look like this shit. Kombucha. Kombucha. Quads Craft by the Forty Ranch. Sweet has a very enticing smell, kind of like a rancy. Kombucha. Comes from, bred by the Boone Acres. They say you're gonna feel it in your eyes immediately. It's a sour D and a purple punch. Yeah, that's what it is. And that purple punch shining through. And what the hell is purple punch? What is purple punch? Yeah, I got my glasses on. I was gonna look for my phone here and type it in. That's not gonna work right now. Stuff looks super impressive. I put a little clip up of this bud being up close and personal and busted open. We will have that included in the video. What was they doing? Oh yeah, purple punch. So what's everybody growing out there, right? These are two jet fuels, two white widows, and Sheik Van Kuch. That little mini me there on the side. Yeah, these are my ghetto glasses. At least I can still see though. Might waste a little bit of smoke on this one just with it being the first toke in many hours. That flavor and the sweetness, even when I licked my lips just now. So sweet. That has such a beautiful flavor. It's smooth. There's no bite in my throat. There's no nothing there that's like unpleasant. Larry OG and Granddaddy Perks. Right. Larry OG and Granddaddy P. That's what makes up the purple punch. Granddaddy Purple. Well, you shine through beautifully on this strain, Granddaddy. Absolutely beautifully. Larry OG. What the hell makes Larry OG up? Let's see. I love breaking it down. I like knowing what's what. Larry OG, aka Lemon Larry, Sour Larry, Zour Larry, and Zour Larry. Okay, it just spelled a little different, you guys. Come on. I like going on AllBud. It's a really good site. AllBud gives you a really good, it's like WikiLeap. Larry OG, it's OG Kush and SFB OG. Nice. I got some SFB OG beans that I've really been interested in popping. But that'll be some other day. I got some Gas F3s, some Blackberry F2s. Really excited about that Blackberry. You think I'd be excited about the Gas, but I don't know, that Blackberry, it's like I already could visualize what she was going to look like when I was holding on to the seed. It was like, plant me. I don't know. Yeah, that GDP really shines through. It really shines through. And then you got that sour D in there, though. It gives it that wild, unique smell mixed with that wicked sweet. Ooh! There's the GDP in there. Hello. You know, last night I actually slept. Well, this morning I woke up with my face on this table here for a little while. And, I got about 4 hours of sleep. I couldn't believe it, you know, because I sleep maximum 30 minutes a night. And that's, like, throughout the day and a night. It's like mini cat naps. I'm too wired all the time, too cranked up. I can't ever sleep. It literally drives me nuts. Sour D, 90% sativa sour diesel, only 10% indica. I really didn't think that. Sour D, hey. Nice. I got some 91 chem dog in a power room. I'd say this really brought me up a couple notches here. Kind of like yesterday morning there, I was feeling kind of like, meh. Add a couple tokes and boot doo doo. Ready to go again. Let's kind of give Kombucha a little bit of a rating here. Her looks are beautiful. Looks, we're hitting 9.7. That's an easy 9.7 on the looks. I know I have looks, taste, structure, ash, and overall. I usually go by 50 points, but we'll do that when we do just a one strain review. Looks, and it goes, it's a little bit different in structure, right? Like, structure, what do we got here? Like, looks, hell yeah, super vivid colors. All 12 to 50 shades of purple, blue. And then you got all these different shades of green. Shit's getting real dark everywhere. You got these real dark, dark, dark hairs. And then there's also spots like Mercy's violet, purple, all different shades of purple. Absolute beautiful weed. Like they say, bud porn. Get your cameras, get your cameras. This shit's about to get real heavy. You know how that is. So I'd say the structure, very dense. The stems on there too are just absolute minuscule. Like there's nothing even there. Even on the big, huge, fat, like 3.5 gram bud there, that thing's got just the teeniest little stems on it. We're gonna go with the 9.7 as well on that. To get any better than that, I'd have to say we'll retort that. We're gonna retort that 9.7. We're gonna bring that up to a 9.8. Because there isn't too much that I could think of that would actually make it. There isn't too much more I could think of that would make it just that, make it hit that 10, you know. Possibly maybe a color, you know, like I'm in search of pink buds. Pink buds or red buds. Pink or red buds. I'm in the search for pink buds. I'm really looking forward to testing out Poivre, or Pave. People are calling it Pave. I think that's more of an English term. I'd say the people that created it there kind of are going with that Poivre. That's why the slash is over the E. Because she's got the menthol in her. Whenever I see the menthol, it's like that. The menthol. I want to grow the menthol so bad. I want to grow the menthol so bad. We're going to try a different hitter here. A little bit more airflow. That sweetness went all the way down my throat, right across my lips, my tongue. Everything just got hit by such a sweet fucking flavor. Wow. Fruity, berry, a little touch of earth, and there is piney. But that sweetness, you know? It's like a purple punch sweetness, you know? It's like, that's what it is. That's some sweet weed. It doesn't got too much of a lung expanding property to it. It's what you breathe in is what you get, and it's just, there's no, like, after that. I did notice my video, even though I did speak loud, I had to crank the shit right out of the TV in order to hear what I was saying. So, when the music kicked in at the end of the video, holy sheep shit. I know, I understand. Okay, we're gonna go with a different airflow here. this one is very small. With this one, I seem to breathe in less air and more smoke. This one's like straight air with the smoke. This is like a 50-50, I swear. And it seemed to give me different feelings. Well, you can hear the difference. You can hear the difference in the coughs. When I smoke it that way, it hits me really deep in the chest. When I get that less oxygen with it. Yeah, like less oxygen. Well, you know what I mean. Like, it's like, with this thing with the two chokes, there's a choke on the bottom and the top, more or less. One for each lip, and then you can choose whether you want to have them on or off. But if you want to have one or two, and it seems to just pull in that smoke, like there's not really smoke there with that air. It's just like there's a lot of air with that smoke. Then that's like a straight 50-50 pull. Yeah, it really is. And then this Bic pen, back to the old school Bic pen, hey, you know. Yeah, and she's got the tip in it, eh? So that's just a small little thing on there. We're gonna have to do the ash report. We're gonna have to do the ash report. So, we're gonna leave that poivre for last. We're gonna be hitting the Gary Payton next. Gary Payton looks like some super fucking sick OG, man. Those buds are dank. They're rock solid. Those are rock solid buds, Gary. Yeah, I'm looking at you, Gary. Again. Let's try to use this little coil heat unit here. Let's try to get the first toke with a vape. Super excited for this. Yesterday, that was awesome when we did this. Is that like Diesel ever come out with that earth? That sweetness is gone. You can smell that sweetness though, mixed with that Diesel. Fuck, I want to get a vape, man. I want to be able to go through these different tastes. Like, damn. Yeah, see, I've always been a blader, right? So just, but, it's kind of like a dab rig, right? I'm not smashing them fucking orange. It takes a little bit of time to get used to the knives you're using, you know? Understanding how long it takes them to cool off, what color you want to see right before you do the touch. It takes a little bit of, you know, understanding your steel. I like this bud. Sweetness just rolled right over again. See when she burnt? Wow, it's just super, super sweet. I can see even on my lips. Like, wow. So I had a fucking drink. There we are. Well, the studio, my living room, it's okay for now, but I don't really think sitting on when I'm this thing is very comfortable, and I don't really like the height at all. Feels kind of ghetto. Feels kind of ghetto, but it works. If there's a will, there's a way. So we just let a little bit of time pass here, try to let that pot do its thing. That toker needs to have one more blast out of it before we can do the ash check. Anybody here play PUBG? PUBG? I used to play a lot of PUBG. When I lived out on the farm, now I'm in town. I never leave my house, even though I'm in town. Damn, I'm hardly on there. So if you've tried adding me and I haven't added you back yet, that's the reason why. It's not that I've checked your stats and done all that. Damn, that weed looks good. I just want to check the time here. It's always a good reminder to myself to check the time until I get my other unit. Alright. Looking alright. We're looking alright. You know, it's all about the White Widow. This, you know? I preferred the, which one is this? Mark that note. Where is my little tags? Why the hell am I missing it? Oh, I guess that's why.
You don't need to put a tag on the last one.
Born October 5th, 2022, White Widow, number 2, or B, well, so it's A that I was thinking was super sexy the whole time. She's got these two buds on A. Sorry, fuck. I don't know how, but when you're trying not to, your clothes will. There's two buds in this one branch right here. I've been watching grow since the beginning. Those are mine. That's going to be my personal smoke for the first 2 weeks when she's ready. 2 weeks? Shit, I don't think it's even going to last 4 days. This smells so good. This White Widow has really got its... It's really got the White Widow nose! You know, the seeds that I got this bud from, it was about 6 years ago, and the pot that it came from looked like Chewbacca balls, orange Chewbacca balls, and there was no density, no nothing, but there was seeds in there, and when I ordered the pot, it said contained seeds, super cheap, whatever. I ordered it just because it said it contained seeds. Well, lo and behold, she came out and turned out fucking fiery. And she was crossed with something because it has this weird MAC look to it, like the color kind of in it when you get close to it. Doesn't look like a real, and A or B does not look like just White Widow. It's got the White Widow feel, the leaves going on and everything, but the kind of the looks, and then also the smell too when you get into it. It's got like an orange, this orangeness. My buddy said, he's like, yeah, it's got that White Widow flavor, smell and everything, but it's got this wicked orange eucalyptus with it, like, not eucalyptus, orange Vicks, like this orange Vicks smell. And you're like, oh, maybe those smells are kind of a White Widow. Well, no, not quite that smell. Like, I've had White Widow so much, and every time I do a grow, I have a White Widow plant. It's just always there. And it, like, from these seeds, I only found two variations, really. One kind of more sativa, one more kind of indica, and there wasn't much change in the characteristics. Now we're talking about the plant. Let's do one more hot knife, and then finish that, caveman. Now it's like straight up sour diesel I'm smoking with the caveman like that. Got more of this diesel-y flavor in my mouth going on. You'll notice that the different airflow is different. You'll have different blades rocking. Oh, pot's working. Pot's working. I'd say that ash is about a 8.2, 8.3, 8.3. Overall, I'm feeling uplifted. I'm not feeling glued to the chair at all. I feel like I could, you know, go do some shit. Go outside and go, you know, shovel some snow or, you know, do some sweeping around here or something, you know. I know if that doesn't make me feel like doing dishes, though. You let me know in the comments if it makes you feel like doing dishes. Any type of weed out there that makes you feel like doing dishes, you let me know. So... she's going to be getting she's got a 9.4. The only reason why she's getting a 9.4 is just because I could be a little bit more stoned. A little bit more stoned would be nice. Right. Yep, definitely a nice string for sure. You want something that's not gonna just blast you back, it's something you can smoke all day. Kombucha is definitely the name. I guess we'll put that with the package drawer. Alright, Gary, you're up. You're up, Gary. Oh, shit. Gotta put this chunker in a bag. Kombucha. Alright, Gary. right, Gary. I've been looking forward to you.
I had one toke at the Gary this morning. Let me say. So there's Gary, pink Wagyu. Wow. We're gonna go through Gary a little bit quicker here. Took a hell of a long time. The smell on Gary is fucking fantastic. You can't go wrong with that. It's like a super solid OG or something. It's just going hard. This Gary is unreal. Gary is the Y crossed with the snowman. And Cookies and Powers collab. Cookies and Powers collab. Apparently it was Cookies and Powers. And then they gave it to somebody. Yeah, they did a pheno hunt on this plant, and I don't have that written down, but the person that seen this plant kept on calling Gary because of the pheno number. The pheno number, and then it was just called Pate because the pheno number, and then it was Gary. It was the Gary Pate. And that's how she came to be. The snowman. That's what I wanted to check out. Oh, just snowman. Probably. Snowman strain. Snowman strain belongs to the exotic family of strains created by the Cookies family. The snowman strain is essentially a cross between the famed Girl Scout cookies, of course, and the Florida Kush. Snowman cookie strain is a slimy, squishy, and trichome-rich strain with genetics from his GSC strain. It's sure not to disappoint. $3.20 an ounce. A leaf. Very interesting. Like I said, I like to just kind of redo and see. Perfect for a lazy afternoon when you want to kick back. Snowman. The snowman crossed with the Y. It's really hard to describe the smell to you. It's not like slamming in your face. It's definitely earthy. It's gassy. I'd say more diesely than gassy. More diesely than gas. Very earthy. Let's see what other people got out of that pull. Mm. flavor isn't jumping out too much at me. Not too much. Very earthy. It's easily. Leafly, what do you got to say to me? Diesel, earthy. That's what it says here for aromas, is earthy, herbal. Diesel, earthy, herbal, and sour. Let's do this drop again. The sour's there for sure, yes. The diesel. And they're earthy. Flavors. Diesel, herbal, spicy, and sweet. Thin, sweet. Not much spice. Herbal it's for sure. But earthy. Hybrid strain. Go up to 50-50. Straight herbal flavor in that. Definitely really very, very herbally.
Herbally.
She's herbally on that one. Well, that the glass tube definitely starts to make me cough, and then the one after that, this small big one here. Well, we'll see what that does. Shut. The Y. What strain is the Y? The Y. The Y strain. So, is shaped like a Y, is used to filter a strain out particulates from steam, gas, or liquid. It's mechanical. Yeah, that's not what we want. That's funny. That's funny. There we go. Boom. Oh, how old am I? Am I in the States or Canada? Canada. Saskatchewan. When were you born? Feels like yesterday. Let's go with that good old August. Rocking on that number 10. Let me in. Hybrid, jealousy, gassy, giggly. The strain jealousy is something that I really want to get my hands on. Where the hell are we? Give me my information! What the fuck? Come on. I should have just put all bud right from the beginning of all this, and we would have been there. See, I like how we can edit that. So if this is the one here, it's Amnesia, the old Amnesia across the Cali Mist. It's Y Griega. And
I told you once, now tell you twice. The way I feel, here's my advice. I told you once, now tell you twice. The way I feel.